Previously on Day Trip to History.
Louise, this is a beautiful horse with all the jewels. What can you tell us about it?
This is an interesting animal, and he happens to be one of my favorites in the room. So you have good taste. This horse was created by Charles Carmel. He was the carousel carver. And then Mr. Borelli, who was a carousel maker, would buy pieces from Charles Carmel, and he would bejewel and bedeck them.
Hi, I'm Bob DeToma. Episode 2 of our visit to the New England Carousel Museum in Bristol, Connecticut. Day Trip to History starts right now.
Now, part 2 of the New England Carousel Museum.
Some machinery.
Yes. This is called a band organ. Band organ is to carousel as calliope is to circus, but it plays the same lilting kind of music that makes everybody smile.
Right.
It's run similarly to a player piano, so you have the perforated rolls of music that are then operated through this machine. Oh, it's a carousel museum without the music.
Sure.
So we're gonna play some of this for you.
Is there a rewind?
Yes. There are approximately 10 songs per roll. As you can see, we have a big variety of rolls. Our band organ expert recommends that we don't use the old band organ rolls that came with the machine because it makes paper dust and it clogs the works.
Ah.
So we have new creations.
Okay.
And with new creations, you can get anything you want.
Wow.
Any song you want, you can have created if you choose
to
do that. We prefer to listen to a lot of the old
sure.
music. But you can do country western, you can do polkas, you can do whatever you want. And we have different roles, as I said, that are appropriate to different times of the year, depending upon the season. We have patriotic marches, we have holiday music, we
sure.
have all kinds of things that we can change this out and play what our visitors want to hear.
Very entertaining.
This actually was pretty mild. We have some that are pretty loud. Yeah, the neat thing about band organs is that there is no volume control. Mm. You've got on and you've got off.
Right.
And we have people come in here all the time saying, can you turn that down? Well, no, we can't.
Yeah.
This is it.
Yeah.
And the band organ we have in Hartford with the Bushnell Park Carousel is bigger and louder.
Wow.
So we get requests to turn that one down all the time.
Sure.
Mostly from the staff. Right?
So Louise, please tell our viewers about these small carousels.
Well, we started acquiring miniature carousels years ago. It wasn't intentional. people just started bringing them to us, and we were really quite surprised by the number of people who created miniature carousels,
sure,
just as a hobby.
Mm-hmm.
And this one in particular is interesting because we learned about this. We used to have here in Bristol Balloons Over Bristol, where the balloonist would come and fly right here in this town, and they did come one year, and the weather took a bad turn and they weren't able to go up. So they wandered the community and found us, and one of the balloonists came in and said, "Have I got a treat for you?" And he came back a few weeks later and he brought us this carousel that he had made, and it's made up of 747 paper clips, which he painstakingly in the 60s straightened out and then redesigned to come up with this carousel. The horses not only go up and down, as you can see, it goes around.
Sure.
And he also made, I'm told, a roller coaster, which is too unwieldy to bring here. But he stops in now once a year when he comes up north to fly. And he stops and he maintains it for us. And it's here for public view. And we're thrilled to have it. It's charming.
Amazing.
But all of the ones that you see here were created by, and we have more throughout the museum.
Sure.
Actually, the Senior Center here in Bristol made three of these and gave us two. And so we have an abundance of miniature carousels.
Wow. And they're all electric powered?
Yeah,
with
well,
the exception of this one.
This one's a hand crank. And I think, yeah, isn't that cute?
Louise, how large is this facility?
Well, this building is 33,000 square feet. It's a restored hosiery factory. They made women's undergarments here. The building was put together originally in 1837. It was part of the Bristol Manufacturing Company, which was a three-building complex. Of the three buildings, this is the only one left standing. Mm. But it makes a splendid backdrop for this subject matter with the wood and the brick background for all of our pieces. I think it displays very well.
Wonderful. Now, you mentioned the expansion, and when did that take place?
When we purchased the building at the end of 1998, we already had a plan in place if we were ever successful enough to get the funding to buy the building, and we were successful at the end of 1998. I had already recommended to our board of directors that we evolve into the Bristol Center for Arts and Culture, wanting to add more to our educational experience here, keeping the Carousel Museum always as the cornerstone, but adding layers of other opportunities here. So we expanded into the rest of the building, splash, and expanded the Carousel Museum and added two fine art galleries on the first floor. Then we upstairs added a Museum of Fire History, a Museum of Greek Culture. We expanded our restoration department, and we created a banquet hall that seats 250 for weddings and bar mitzvahs and all kinds of facility rentals.
Wow, amazing.
So it's been fun.
Lead the way.
Good. It's resin. Yeah, these are not antique wooden carousel pieces.
Okay.
These are out and they're touchables again, it's because they are resin.
Okay.
But we have these for a variety of reasons. We can sell resin pieces. We can sell new carvings and resin pieces. We don't sell the antiques, but we have these for a variety of reasons. That horse that you just knocked on is called one of our community connection horses. So if you call me and say, "I need a carousel horse for my bank lobby, my prom, my wedding, whatever," it's one of these horses that go out. We get lots of calls from theatrical groups doing Carousel the play, asking if they can borrow 4 to 6 horses for their staging. So we have them in reserve to do that kind of thing. We like getting these out into the community because that obviously draws attention to us. This lion is fairly newly done for us. This too is resin.
Mm-hmm.
And we did this in the Lions Club colors, thinking what a neat thing to have to go out to the country fairs that are sponsored by Lions Club.
Sure.
Or any Lions Club event where we put a child sitting on the lion, take a picture of them, and then let the child create its own card to give to their parents or whatever. So we're finding ways to have these pieces earn funding for us.
Wonderful.
The tiger was given to us. Some high school students found it in a dumpster.
Oh, no.
And one of the mothers called us and said, "You're not going to believe, we just found a tiger in a dumpster. Do you want it?" Went, "Of course." We don't say no. And he hasn't been through the process yet, but he will be prime painted and painted so that he looks more of the quality of the lion.
What attracts you to this horse, Louise?
Well, it's basically the same thing as our own Denzel Prancer in the other room, where she is a Muller Denzel and has an absolutely beautiful face and is in, again, original or early paint. And it's hard to come by. It's hard to find pieces that are in that condition coming here.
The face is expressive, too.
It's beautiful. Oh. Yeah, she's a little charmer. When they're like that, they're called sweet face. In this case, you can see also, she has kind of a closed muzzle. It's not completely closed, but if you look around all of the horses in the museum, most of them have a pretty wide open muzzle. You rarely see, unless you go to East Providence, to the Loof Carousel, horses that have a completely closed muzzle. And remember, we talked about anything unusual about the animal adds to the value. So all of those closed mouth horses would have tremendous value because their mouths aren't open like all of their cousins.
And how did this piece come to you?
All of these pieces belong to a collector from Baltimore. And he called me a few years ago and said he had heard wonderful things about the museum and was interested in putting a portion of his collection in here. And so I said, that's wonderful. Why don't you come up, meet with myself and my board president and get comfortable with us, and we'll talk about taking in some of your collection. And then he phoned me the next morning and he said, the truck is on its way. And it'll be there late this afternoon. And I went, this room was full. And so I went, oops. And so we started rearranging to accommodate what was coming to us. And everything you see in here is from his private collection.
And you mentioned that the wives of the owners of the collections are happy to see them go?
Thrilled. Yeah. One woman told me, we got a giraffe at one point. It's no longer here, but at one point we got a massive giraffe that we took in, and she was delighted because it had been years since she'd been able to clean behind it, because it was just such a massive piece.
Wow.
But we, on that occasion, also took 18 pieces out of that house. So these are obviously very large homes, and they have carousel pieces in every room. And the wives are thrilled to pieces to have their house free again. And it's interesting to me that so many of them are collected by men. And women are enjoying them, but it's really the man who is driving the collection.
Mm. I think men are collectors and women are admirers.
Huh? Not
you
in
think?
My house.
No? Louise, I love the giraffe. Tell me about him.
Well, he's a PTC, a Philadelphia Toboggan Company animal. And his kind of name to fame is that as you walk by him, our visitors insist that his eyes follow you.
Well, let me walk by and take a look. It actually does. Oh, that is amazing.
Huh, he's a beauty.
Lions, tigers, and bears.
This is a tiger that was created by Frederick Hein, and he was a German carver. Mm-hmm. And this one is particularly splendid. If you come around and take a peek at his face, you're going to see that he is pretty ferocious.
Fierce is correct.
He is pretty ferocious. And he happens to be a prancer. And two legs down, two hooves up, so he would not have gone up and down on a ride. Gives him the impression of pouncing on you.
Yes. So earlier, Louise, you mentioned farm animals and carousels.
Yes.
And so here we have...
Well, this is a Bayeux cow, and he was known for his farm animal carving. And as we go to other galleries in the building, you'll see more rabbits especially and pigs that he created. This cow came to us when animals were sent to us from Marshall Fields in Chicago. Mm-hmm. The curator there contacted us a few years ago. They were closing down getting rid of a lot of the things they had in storage, and they selected us to receive their pieces. So at that time, we got about 11 carousel pieces from them. It's our first cow, and so we think it's adorable.